Hey, what's up guys, I'm here and this is the gaming controller from Gamesir, the G4S. This is the first time I'm reviewing a gaming controller on my channel. I'm not a big gamer but knows very well is it worth it or not. To extract out the review, I just hunted for some few things. First, the design. Second, how much it's comfortable to hold or play the games. Third, the battery life. As every device, whether it is a smartphone, smartwatch, camera or this controller, we all need a good battery so we can enjoy as long as we want. First thing about the design, it's fully made up of plastic, a solid plastic, with some silver rails on both the side of the midway, and four top keys which are also in silver color, but made up of plastic. On both of the ends, there are grips to hold it more comfortable so it won't slip out while playing or sweating coming out from our hands. Quite easy to hold and play without any issue. ABX swipe buttons which are tactile and make sound while clicking, and also they glow. One left analog stick which is on the top left corner as we see in Xbox controller. Not like a Sony PlayStation controller in which both the analog keys are on the middle section, but in this it's like an Xbox. It's familiar to that. Beneath that, a D-pad which is in combination of silver and black color, and a right analog stick, select start button, a battery indicator which is obviously a good thing so that we can check the battery percentage level on the gaming controller, and a power button on the midway. Actually, it has some multiple options. It is used to switch between Bluetooth and Android. You need to just hold it with either A or X. If you press A, then it is good to go with Bluetooth, especially Android. But if you press X, then it is for Wi-Fi, which works on 2.4 GHz and you can use it with smart TVs or PCs. And the middle part, which hides some other keys like turbo and clear, and a mobile holding stand. Just lifting up and putting our phone, connect it and play. And a USB Wi-Fi 2.4 GHz to connect it with PC or TVs. Overall build quality is quite good, but few things which I don't like are sound making keys. D-pad is quite great, it doesn't make any sound, but these ABXY keys and also top 2 keys, they make sound when we click it like this. But with the other 2 keys, we need to press it deep, then it will react. There is so much space in it. See this, we need to press it so long to make it touch inside. Anyway, that seems not so bad, as we will have a chill of that. Not a big issue. There is a charging micro USB jack. We can use any normal phone charger to charge it. It takes about 2.5 hours to charge it completely and has a battery of 800 mAh, which gives the battery backup of about 15 hours, which is awesome in my opinion. It's an amazing controller. Great look, good build and design, if we ignore some minor things. But what about using it? So let's play some games both in PC and smartphone. So this is the FIFA 15 in PC. As from the beginning of FIFA games, I used to play with controllers. And to use skills, we definitely need analog sticks. Really quite an amazing experience. Now let's try some shooting games like the Battlefield 1 2016 or Black Ops 3. As it's quite difficult in beginning to control the movement of axes if we are habitual of mouse. But there's not any kind of lagginess or latency. It runs smooth, not any kind of interruption. We can sit far away from our PC and enjoy the games as it is wireless. Let's try another game, which is GTA 5, a best open world game. Roaming around the streets, killing pedestrians, enjoyed a lot. It detects an Xbox controller in PC, so the games which work with an Xbox controller will also work with this, almost all. You can find out the compatible game list in the description box link. Now time to move to smartphone and let's try Asphalt first. Feeling very handy, it's very reliable too. Controls are great enough. No issue in playing games with this. And let's play one more game, which is again FIFA. It's FIFA 16. And again, I don't want to repeat the same thing like skills as I said in FIFA 15 PC game. Overall, it's a great controller. Nice job by the Gamesir. Good thing is that we can use it with both PC and phones. The price tag is ₹3300 on Amazon. And you can get the Best Buy link down in the description box below. Anyway, this is a great controller, totally worth the price. You should definitely give it a try. You will not regret it. So that's pretty much it. Hopefully you enjoyed the video, and if you did, then make sure to give a huge thumbs up and subscribe the channel, and also enable the bell notification to get notified after every upload. Thank you guys for watching, and I will talk to you guys later.